Ladies and gentlemen, we are currently in the middle of a double XP weekend, and you are going to get all this XP to have a chance to get the boss packs in the Season 3 XP reward path. And if you're done the Season 3 XP reward path, you want to spin the spiel as many times as possible to get boss packs and an all-star pack, diamond duos, show packs, and even chase packs, and also stubs as well. So you want to do this XP method as much as possible to get as many chances to spin this wheel as possible and get as many rewards as possible. If you enjoyed this video, hit that like button and subscribe. It truly helps me out a ton, and it's completely free. Let's get into it. First thing you want to do is get out of Diamond Dynasty. Then you want to go to the Create tab. You're going to go to Vault. You're going to next go to Roster Vault, and you want to sort. I know you guys can't really see this, but you want to sort by downloads descending. If not, you can just search. But what you're going to want to download is United Gaming Road to the Show XP method. You want to download this roster right here. If you want, you can just search it up. United Gaming Road to the Show XP method. You need this roster to be downloaded. So I already have it downloaded, so we don't even need to worry about that. So next thing you want to do is you want to go to Road to the Show. You want to create a brand new Road to the Show. Alright, so we're here to start your career. You want to select a roster, you want to load saved roster, you want to make sure that you load the correct roster, the United Gaming Road to the Show XP roster. If you're not loading this roster, it will not end up correctly, and there's a really clear way to tell if you load the roster. Next, we're going to start with our active ball player. Doesn't matter what kind of ball player it is, it just has to be a position player. So we got Tortilla Chip here. And he is going to basically go on the phone right now with the scout, and you can say whatever you want here. It does not matter at all. So this is the thing that matters. So you say, no, I'd prefer to play for a different team. And if you see first across the board for the Orioles here, I know my face cam kind of cuts it off, but it says first. So if it says first for the Orioles here, you're going to want to select the Orioles. And if you don't see first, that means you didn't use the correct roster. So it doesn't matter what you say. Now, no matter what, you are going to get drafted by the Baltimore Orioles. It literally does not matter what you do. As long as you select the Orioles, you're going to get drafted by them. So that's a nice little touch. So you can just select the Orioles, and you're, boom, you're automatically on the best team in Major League Baseball. What does this mean? I'll show you. The rest of the league is all zero overalls. And your team is all 99 overalls. So let's just take a look at the league. Actually, there's no. Let's take a look at rosters. So let's see. Everyone is a 99 overall, except for you. But everyone's a 99 overall. Then we go to other teams, and boom, they are all terrible. I don't know why the freaking, I don't know. It doesn't matter. They're double A. The point is that all the double A rosters are all zero overall. Some MLB rosters, I was too lazy to change. But you shouldn't make it to MLB anyway. So that's just more work. Anyway, what you're going to do before you get into anything, you want to go to League. And this is only if you're on next-gen console. You want to go to Stadium Assignment. So we're going to be playing our first series in Hartford. So we do want to change that stadium. So basically you want to do a Stadium Assignment. And you want to change all of the stadiums to basically a Juice Stadium. So we are actually going to go to Hartford and just change that one to save ourselves some time. No Ship It Stadium. We do not want Ship It Stadium. We want XP Grind Stadium. All the walls are all the way in. Max elevation. Hit as many home runs as possible. And you are going to get so much XP by doing this method. It is absolutely insane. Get upwards of 30,000 XP. Especially with double XP, you're going to get a ton more. So now that that's loaded, you want to go to settings and you want to take a look. Gameplay, hitting difficulty should be on beginner, and the hitting interference should be on directional. I don't know why it wasn't on directional, but it should be on directional. All right, now that it's on directional, you want to go to mode specific here, and you want to turn base running opportunities on none and fielding opportunities on none unless you want to. And I don't recommend it. It's not as fast. I recommend just doing hitting opportunities. Next, you just want to load into your first ever game, and all you're going to want to do is hit a bunch of freaking dingers. It is not really all that difficult. So we're going to load in. We're ready. We're set. Tortilla Chip's ready for his professional baseball debut, and they are going to lob 80-mile-an-hour fastballs right down the middle, and you are going to just aim upwards and hit an absolute freaking dinger. It's really not that complicated of a method. So just lob the 85-mile-an-hour fastball right down the middle, and you're going to get tons of at-bats in a game. As you can see, we're up for the second time in the third inning. It's already 8-0, and we are going to hit our second home run of the game just like that. Very, very simple. Fastballs right down the middle with the Juice Stadium. Even if you miss hit it, you're still likely going to hit a home run. And boom, we're up again in the fourth. Basically, you're just going to get at-bat after at-bat after at-bat. And the longer the games go, the more at-bats you're going to get. So each game takes around 2 minutes to complete. On average, it takes about 2 minutes to complete. And that's in average on games, you're going to get between 6 to 9 at-bats per game. Looking like this is not going to be a good game. We're only putting up 14 in the sixth, which I know it sounds like a lot, but doesn't look like we're going to get a ton of XP for this game. But we're still going to get a lot of XP for this game. You'll get more XP depending on if there's bad runners on base, stuff like that. Looks like this is actually a really, really bad game. Christ, we're not even going to get 6 at-bats. This is a really bad one. Normally, you get about 7 or so we might have to play a whole nother game to fully, like, demonstrate the power of this. And, okay, we're gonna get our 6 at-bat at least. And there's a runner on second, so we'll be able to get some more for actually hitting a 2-run home run this time. So, boom, 2-run home run, perfect. You can do this basically just watching Netflix. This is very mind-numbing. All you gotta do is just hit X and point up. It's really not that difficult of a method. 6 at-bats, that's a little bit lower than usual, but then again, it was a quicker game than usual. We got 1,000 XP for that game. So that was a little under 2 minutes that time, just because of how short the game actually was. So I think we are gonna play another one, but I do wanna show you guys some things real quick first. So we got 1,000 XP in about 2 minutes, and that was a poor game. So this is a little bit low on standard. So you are guaranteed 30,000 XP per minute, and this is on a bad game. So you can play this, you can play about 30 games in an hour, and you can get, and each game takes 2 minutes, so you can play 30 games in an hour, and you get 1,000 XP per game, so 30,000 XP, and that's a very poor one. Another way you can get XP is through the programs here, if you haven't done these programs yet. Take a look, if you take see tasks and rewards, boom, you just get XP from completing all these missions. Just by playing the game, you're going to get progress in these programs, and you have a chance for tons of XP by doing this. This is just extra XP added onto the XP you're already getting. So this is a big method. We're actually going to play one more game because that was a pretty bad game per this method standards. Usually you're going to score 30 or so runs per game, not about 15. Normally you end up playing a lot more than that. So we're going to, boom, we're already up on the first. So we're just going to try and get an actual, like, good playthrough in before we wrap up this video. Boom, another bomb, absolutely clobbered. We have hit a home run every single lap out of our MLB career so far. And that's basically what you're going to do. You're going to get out every once in a while. Stuff happens, you know, that it's a game. It's not perfect. You're going to hit into the occasional line drive. You're going to get a double or so. Stuff's going to happen. But normally, you should go 7-for-7 or 8-for-8 with just a bunch of homers. It's not that difficult. And even if your ball players are not as high of stats as mine, you're still going to hit a bunch of bombs considering the stadium is in a lot. If you're not on next-gen console, do not worry. It is still going to be a very effective method even if you can't go to this stadium. If you're on PS4 or Xbox One or whatever the original Xbox is called, if you're still playing on those consoles, there's nothing really to worry about. You're still going to get a ton of XP, and this is another bad game. God damn, what is up with this save and just not giving me tons of at-bats? Like, what are we doing here? Come on, give me up again. All right, we should be able to get, hopefully able to get at least 7 at-bats this game. I'm just having terrible luck right now. The Yard Goats are kind of crushing us. I mean, they're not crushing me. I'm hitting bombs left and right. But, you know, overall, they're kind of killing our team a bit. All right, we're going to get at least 6 at-bats in. If not, we'll get, probably get the 7th one in too. And I, as you see, I've just hit a bunch of homers. And you can power swing or normal swing if you want. It's up to you. That's really, doesn't really matter all that much what you do, power or normal swing. I've done a bit of both. Power swinging, obviously you're going to hit the ball further, and I think if you're on current gen consoles, you do need to pay a little bit more attention. You can't just be on your phone, you know, watching something and doing this at the same time. It's going to make it a little more difficult. So we finished that, 7 at-bats, and got a little bit over 1,000 XP. So you're probably going to actually average about 33,000 XP per hour, so more like 35,000 XP per hour. So tons of XP by doing this method, tons of potential, and I recommend doing this as much as you can over this weekend or until August 22nd when the double XP ends. So thank you guys so much for watching today's video. If you enjoyed, please hit that like button and subscribe. Only a small percentage of people who watch my videos are actually subscribed. I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace out.